ATR or Dash 8, which is the safest? That's what I will talk about today. Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magnar Nordal, I'm an ATR captain and instructor. The ATR aircraft and the Dash 8 are two of the most iconic and widely used regional turboprop aircraft ever built. For more than four decades, these two aircraft have competed for the same customer base, dominating the regional aviation sector. Their reliability, efficiency, and versatility have made them popular choices for airlines and operators around the world. In this video, I will take an in-depth look at the safety records on both the ATR and Dash 8. As someone who has flown the ATR for over 25 years, I admit it is challenging for me to remain entirely neutral. But to ensure an objective comparison, I will focus purely on the facts and let the data speak for itself. Ultimately, I will leave the judgment to you, the viewer. Here is the methodology I have used. I have counted every hull loss incident listed in the Aviation Safety Network, ASN, which is managed by the Flight Safety Foundation. The ASN provides detailed records of aviation accidents and incidents worldwide, offering valuable insight into the safety performance of various aircraft types. Here I will present the raw data, allowing us to examine the safety histories of both aircraft and evaluate the relative performance in terms of hull losses. Let's dive into the numbers and see how the ATR and Dash 8 compare. This doesn't look good for ATR. ATR has delivered more than 1,700 aircraft, and about 1,300 Dash 8 have been delivered. That means there have been roughly 30% more ATRs than Dash 8s. But the loss of ATRs doubles that of Dash 8. However, statistics can be deceiving.
76% of motorists involved in traffic accidents consume coffee daily.
When examining the first category, parked, there is a noticeable discrepancy. However, it is important to remember that an aircraft design should not be held responsible for damage that occurs while it's stationary on the ground. A total of 8 ATRs have been damaged by severe weather events such as hurricanes and tornadoes. Other ground incidents include engine run-ups gone wrong, hangar fires, armed conflicts, and collisions with other aircraft or vehicles. Ground accidents are generally considered to be survivable, as they often occur at low speeds. However, there are tragic exceptions. One such instance was the heartbreaking accident involving a Japan Coast Guard Dash 8 last year. In this case, the aircraft mistakenly lined up on an active runway without clearance and was subsequently struck by a landing Airbus. Two ATRs were involved in incidents where the aircraft was not properly de-iced before takeoff, a cardinal error. The first ATR prototype was lost during a training flight when control was lost after simulating an engine failure at takeoff. The final ATR on this list was lost when the aircraft overran the runway during a high-speed abort. Investigation revealed that improper loading made it impossible for the pilot to rotate the aircraft. As for the Dash 8, one Dash 8-400 was lost after its landing gear was retracted before the aircraft became airborne. This model was designed so that the landing gear could be retracted once the nose wheel was off the ground. There were also two incidents of runway excursions where the aircraft went off the runway, and one instance where the aircraft struck animals on the runway. One ATR-42 stalled during climb after encountering severe icing conditions. The aircraft was climbing at a speed below the minimum operating speed for icing conditions. During the upset, the pilot attempted to recover by pulling against the stick pressure 3 times and trimming the elevator fully nose down, which made recovery impossible. One ATR-72 was written off after an engine fire, and another ATR-72 crashed after the crew shut down the operating engine after the other had failed. This was a tragic cause of Transasia Flight 235, which I have previously discussed in this video. Lastly, the final ATR crash occurred when the flight crew departed before the gyros had fully stabilized, entered cloud cover, and collided with high terrain. This is where the ATR really faces challenges. But is it due to the aircraft's design, or are there other contributing factors? There are three accidents involving ATR aircraft during cruise and related to icing conditions. Severe icing resulted in excessive aerodynamic drag, causing the aircraft to lose speed. Unfortunately, the flight crew did not act in time and the aircraft stalled. Additionally, they did not follow the correct stall recovery procedure, including selecting flap 15. These types of incidents are not unique to ATR aircraft. Ice-related accidents have occurred with Dash 8, Airbus, Boeing, and MD-80, as discussed in this video. The reality is, no aircraft is immune to the dangers of ice. Two ATRs were lost due to suicide-related incidents. Two others were lost to fuel starvation, and two more were lost as a result of system failures related to maintenance issues. In at least one of these cases, the loss could have been prevented had the crew reacted appropriately in response to the situation. One ATR-42 was lost after a pitch tree moved to full nose-down position. The accident report is inconclusive but suggests two possible causes: a malfunction in the pitch trim system, or the captain accidentally placing an object, like a manual, on the pedestal, which pushed the standby pitch trim switch to the nose down position. Shortly before the trim runaway, the captain announced he will change clothes and moved behind the pedestal. 5 seconds before the trim started moving, the flight data recorder event push button was pressed. This button is located near the trim switch. Even the switch has a guard, it may have been left open after first officer tested it before the flight. Following this incident, ADR added a protective rail around the trim switches. The losses involving the Dash 8 were due to hail that caused irreparable damage, a suicide event, and a military aircraft involved in drone patrol in Colombia. The details surrounding the military aircraft's loss are not known to me. The first ATR loss during approach involved American Eagle Flight 4184, which crashed due to a combination of severe icing, a condition no aircraft at the time was certified to handle, improper procedures, and a design flaw in the de-icing boots. The boots did not cover enough of the upper wing surface, causing an ice ridge to form behind them. This disrupted the airflow over the wing, resulting in uneven pressure distribution over the ailerons, causing them to deflect fully and ultimately leading to a loss of control. This video explains how these factors contributed to the crash. This accident also helped shape the impression that ATRs are unsafe in icing conditions. However, the NTSB report reveals that the real issue was the limitations of manually operated ailerons and pneumatic de-icing boots. Design features common to all regional turboprop aircraft, not just ATR. There have been 5 controlled flight into terrain, CFIT, accidents involving ATR aircraft, and 1 accident with a Dash 8. 1 ATR was lost after an engine fire spread to the wing following landing. Additionally, 2 ATRs and 4 Dash 8s were lost due to what I refer to as mismanagement or loss of control. This includes Colgan Air Flight 3407, where they cruised all the aircraft, a topic I discuss further in this video. Another Dash 8 was lost when the pilot selected reverse thrust in flight. 1 ATR-42 was lost after the flaps failed to extend on final approach, and the crew continued, aiming for approach speed with landing flaps, stalled and crashed short of the runway, a topic covered in this video. Lastly, there was an accident in Nepal where the crew feathered both propellers. You can find more details in this video. 2 ATRs and 1 Dash 8 were lost due to loss of situational awareness during go-around. Additionally, an ATR hit a perimeter wall before the runway end, before climbing out safely. Here's a video about that story. Most landing accidents occur because the approach wasn't properly stabilized, often resulting in a runway excursion. Some aircraft hit animals on the runway, a danger linked to operations in remote areas. Personally, I have experienced a go-around because of dogs running on the runway. ATR aircraft have a reputation for bouncing on landing, but this can be avoided. Check out this video for more. On the other hand, the Dash 8 is known for issues with the landing gear, including gear collapse or one of the landing gear struts failing to fully extend and lock into position. So, which aircraft is safer, ATR or Dash 8? The truth is, statistics can be misleading because most of the accidents we have discussed could have occurred with any aircraft type. The reality is that human factors are often the primary contributors to these incidents. Accidents rarely happen because of a single mistake. Instead, they are typically the result of a chain of events that culminate in an accident. In my view, both aircraft are equally safe. What we need to keep focusing on is human factors. Every day, new pilots are entering the system, and we cannot afford to become complacent. We must continue to work toward creating a safe environment for everyone involved in aviation. What do you think? How can we improve pilot training and the working environment to ensure better safety? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below here. And that is all for this time. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day and happy learning.
One hundred.